Morning, church. I'd like to welcome you in this morning. this service of worship. If you are visiting with us, we're glad you're here. My name is Preston. If you're ready for another song, folks, it's sure good to see y'all too. Just a few announcements.
I actually have several announcements, and this is exciting that we are to a place where we're starting to have more and more announcements. More and more things are beginning to happen in the life of our church as we move forward. Next Sunday, Operation Christmas Child boxes are due. So you need to have those turned in. Poinsettias, if you would like to purchase a poinsettia, the deadline is November 22nd, so we got 2 more weeks, and you can put this, attach it to your money, and put it in the offering box if you like, or you can drop it by the church office. Deacon votes, if you still have not voted for deacons, you can, but right after the service, we'll be counting. Deacons that are rolling off will be counting this year, so... the ballot boxes, if you go out to the sanctuary and to your right. Next Saturday from 9 to 11 is a church work day. So if you are interested in coming and got a little time, want to do some good work around the church, be glad here. Let us know that you're coming. We're going to stop by and pick up some biscuits for folks. And then next Sunday at 10 o'clock, hopefully weather permitting this time, we're going to do our outdoor service. So we'll do it out in front of the church office, and folks will be able to gather out on the lawn in separated places. And then also folks can park along in the parking lot and be able to listen. So it'll be hopefully something different. We'll be able to sing. And I'm looking forward to that. And I hope y'all are too. And then our final announcement is... This Monday is Veterans Day, and we want to celebrate the veterans that we have in our midst. And if so, if there are any veterans at this moment, if you would stand and be recognized. We gather this morning as the people of God to worship. We gather this morning to praise the Almighty, and we gather this morning to give thanksgiving. Would you join me in prayer, please? Gracious God, we come with this opportunity before us to lift you up, to praise your name, to say that you are our God. We know that you are here with us. And help us seize this moment to worship you in spirit and in truth. Amen.
Good morning. Today's scripture comes from Isaiah chapter 40, verses 27 through 31. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Would you join me in prayer, please? Holy, Creator God, God of creation, God of love, and God of hope, we come declaring as your people how great and how good you are. We give thanks, God, for the ways that you walk beside us, the blessings that you bestow on us. We come acknowledging how you are more than we can ever imagine. God, as we move forward as weary travelers on a journey, we look to you for hope. And God, sometimes in the midst of the loud, in the midst of the hard, that we have found ourselves losing hope, putting our hope in other things or in ourselves. And God, we come confessing, God, that we are supposed to keep our eyes fixed on you, to find hope in you, to find our strength in you. And as we find this life, as we find this hope, that we are to radiate out into this world that we live, so we can show how good and how great you are. Forgive us, O God, when we fall short. And God, as we come as pilgrims, moving one foot in front of the other, there is much on our heart, much on our mind that weigh heavy on us. Of vocational concerns, of relational, of health, our emotional concerns we have, God. And as overwhelming as they might be, God, help us to know your presence. And as we find your presence in the midst of the loud, in the midst of the hard, when it's hard to find hope, help us begin to radiate that presence, that presence of care, that presence of concern and love for ones who are struggling among us. And as we close this morning, let us close in the prayer that Jesus taught his followers to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Who seems to will not let you fall.
Whoever tells us that faith is easy is lying to us. They're not giving us a complete picture. Maybe they don't have enough depth to their faith. Because having faith is hard. It's not about having all the answers. It's not about knowing which way we're going. Faith is often about celebrating and trusting in the good times and trusting and putting one foot in front of the other during the hard, during the painful. And we encounter a group of folks this morning, the Jewish nation, that was in the midst of exile. They were a group of people, I believe, they were struggling with their faith. They were far from home. They were under captivity. Life was not normal for them. They had lived under this captivity by this time for 60 years. So generations after generation had come through. They were living outside of Tel Aviv, which was about 50 miles outside of where their home was. And they had longed for Jerusalem. I'm sure the older ones told stories to the young ones about how great it was and how good that place was. And they waited and longed for expectation. With the return of that promise of a new beginning. And Isaiah had the opportunity, the job of speaking to these folks about the matters of faith. Folks who were discouraged, who were depressed, who were feeling hopeless, who were tired and weary. And we see in verse 27, He begins to lament. And whether he's voicing his own feelings or just the feelings of the community, they believed that God had forgotten about them. They felt abandoned, that Yahweh did not care anymore. So the Jewish people were riddled with doubts and with questions. Was Yahweh with them? Does God still care? Does God have any plans for us moving forward? This was a tough group of people to talk to, I can imagine. So imagine the nation downcast as Isaiah began to talk with them. Probably at first, maybe they weren't even too interested. But he begins to remind them earlier in the passage in verse 21, he reminds them and says, have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood? Basically, Isaiah was saying to the folks who were listening, have you forgotten everything? Have you forgotten who God is? Isaiah begins to remind them. God is the one who sits above the earth. A God who is with them. A God who is a creator of the world. By no means had God forgotten about you. God deeply cares for you as a nation. In Isaiah in verse 28, is where we began reading this morning, reiterates this reminding language again. Do you not know? Have you not heard that God is everlasting? God is great. God is powerful. God doesn't grow tired or weary. God understands more than you know, and a speaker needs to know his or her audience. And Isaiah knew his audience. His audience was tired and weary. It wasn't just the old, but the young. We're all struggling. And the prophet was encouraging the nation to keep their gaze, their fix on Yahweh. That as they hope, as they waited in the Lord, they would re-encounter a God who cared. They would be reminded of a God who gave power to the weak. A God who would sustain the weary. They would encounter a God where they would find strength from the Lord. And he begins to use this beautiful imagery of an eagle. They shall mount up on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. And maybe we can relate a little bit to the nation of Israel. We haven't been in captivity for 60 years. We haven't been displaced from our homes, but we've walked through a year where a lot has transpired. It has taken a toll on us emotionally, physically, relationally, vocationally, and spiritually. And there have been times where our heart has ached, where we've been anxious, we've been in fear, we've had anxiety, we've worried. And instead of being able to be together, where we could draw strength from one another, we are told to keep our distance. So we are struggling. We are weary. We are frustrated. We are depressed. And some are even angry. So in this past year, we've had our doubts. We've had our questions. We've had our concerns. We've tried to cope the best way we can, to find ways to lift our spirits. So we've looked to find hope in others. But as we've looked to find that hope, we realize they are just as limited as we are and as struggling as much as we do. Maybe we've tried to put our hope in our own strength. Either mentally or physically, we're strong, but we've all have our limits. We've gotten tired. In my almost 40 years of life, this is the most depressed I've ever been. And instead of trying to fight against the current setting, or fixing things for themselves, Isaiah encouraged the struggling nation to keep their eyes fixed on the Lord. And we are a struggling people, putting our hope sometimes in things that have limits, putting our hope in things that may be unhealthy, trying to fix things for ourselves, or attempting to live in a way hoping that things would just get back to normal. But we have this opportunity to keep our eyes fixed on the Lord, to keep pouring our hearts out to God, or maybe just sitting in the presence of God. Because there have been times I've been so sad, I've been so frustrated, I've been so anxious, I've been so angry, that I go out on my back porch and I want to spend time with God and I want to tell God how I feel, but there's no words. So all I can do is just sit. But I believe in those moments, whether we are talking with God or sitting still, that allows time for the Spirit of God to mesh within our spirit, and we can begin to find that hope. That is where we will have the gumption to keep going, to run and not be weary, to walk and not be faint. Over the 8.5 months, I've struggled to find hope. I've tried to put my hope in my own abilities. It worked for a while, but then I hit a wall. I hope that other folks would fix things. I've hoped to find things in just temporary things that maybe lift my spirit in the moment, but then it just reminded me of the current reality that we lived in. Confession time. In the last 8.5 months or so, I have struggled to open up the scriptures. I have struggled to read it. I've had no desire. I've read from the Psalms, but it's just been really hard to open up the Bible, and I don't know why. And I stumbled on this passage in Isaiah back in early March, and it was reminded me of a time where it carried me through another part of my journey. I began to read it, and I've gone back to it, and I've begun to reread it and memorize it and say it to myself, especially when I didn't have time to open up the scriptures. And it has spoke to me. It has carried me. It has helped me find hope when I've been tired and I've been weary. On the days that I have struggled greatly. Now, trying to lead in a moment like this has been hard when I'm struggling myself. And on the days I struggle more, I read that passage and I recall that passage to myself so I can remind myself where my hope comes from. So as we close, I'm going to reread this passage to remind us where we can find our hope. That as we walk through a time, having faith is hard, living life is hard. And whether we are soaring or whether we are struggling to put one foot in front of the other, we can find our hope in God. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not grow tired or weary, and his understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youth will faint and be weary, and young will fall exhausted. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up on wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not be faint. So now is a time of invitation. If one wants to make their faith public this morning, saying that they want to follow Jesus with their life, if they want to make him Lord and Savior, I invite you to come. Or if there's someone who wants to join in this congregation as a follower of faith, saying yes, they want to continue this kingdom work alongside of us, I invite you to come now in this time. I'm going to ask you to break the rules for a second. Take off your mask so they can see your face. This morning, I come and celebrate with you. Christian Rasko has said that he wants to make his faith public, that he wants to follow Jesus with his life. And if you rejoice in that decision, let it be known by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Christian, as you know, there are people in that row that your family, and they love and support you, and they celebrate with you on this day. But as you look out here, around you and know that there are a lot of other people that are not here that are watching on TV that are a part of your family of faith. Now, these are your grandparents and your brothers and your mama and your daddy, but these are your aunts and your uncles in faith, your grandparents in faith, and they want to support you in this journey. They want to help you learn about Christ. But just know, as you learn about following Jesus every day of your life, know as that you learn from them that you have something to teach us about faith and teach this community about faith. So in a moment, as we close in that, Christian, I'm going to ask you to walk down the aisle, stand where your daddy is, and your family's going to come and stand there, and I'm going to stay back here. And the folks are going to come by. They might smile and wave at you. They might give you a fist bump. But we celebrate with you in this moment and you wanting to follow Jesus and live your life. So know that this is a lifelong process. You won't learn it tomorrow. You won't learn it next week. But you will learn it the rest of your days. We celebrate with you this morning. So as we go as a people, we go with our eyes fixed on God, knowing that He walks beside us, that He loves us, that we find our hope in Him. Amen. Amen. You are dismissed.